Guru, a 1997 Malayalam film which was India's official entry for the Oscars, a political fantasy drama which is the most relevant in 2020. It is a must watch, and if you haven't seen it, you can watch it on YouTube with subtitles. Link will be in the description. Go check it out. Hello guys, Nona Prince, and today we are talking about the Malayalam film Guru, story and direction by Rajiv Anchal, written by C.G. Rajendra Babu, starring Mohan Lal, Suresh Gopi, Madhupal and many more. This is an amazing film. I just love the idea and the concept of it. This is what true fantasy is for me. A fictional setup which is commenting on a real society. Technically, for 1997, this film is amazing. There are some brilliant shots, but it is sad to say that there are not good prints available to watch this film. The best quality available was 720p, and that too was grainy. The scale of this film, oh my god. The locations, the sets, the props, the costumes. Such a wonderful job. They even tried CG and VFX works, and that is commendable. For today's standards, it is nothing. But I don't mind it because the writing was the king of this film. Now there are some issues in the film for me. We'll talk about that later, but before that, it is brilliant that this film came out in 1997. It just amazes me. It is the most relevant film in 2020, even after 23 years later. Because the issues that have doomed the human civilization, they are still the same. Throughout history, we have created division on race, gender, color, religion, each and everything that you can find. And the film sets up perfectly the Hindu-Muslim issue in the beginning of the film that is still plaguing India today. From there, we transition to a fictional world where the issues are still the same. And the brilliancy in the writing is that their blindness is a metaphor for the people blinded by faith in reality. I love this. I just love this. They all believe that sight doesn't exist, and they all follow it like sheep and not question it because it's in the name of faith and God. Our faith is our safety. Oh my god, what a line. This has to be the line of human existence. Anyone who dares to question is a non-believer. Does all of this ring a bell? If it doesn't, just open a news channel. And there comes someone with vision. One who can see the true reality. A guru who's here to show the true path. Each scene is a gem and a lesson. Even Plato's cave is referenced. If you don't know that, go Google it. And when all of this is juxtaposed to the first 30 minutes of the film, we can create the correlations between it. I'm so happy with the ending of the fantasy land as well as the reality. In fantasy land, Raghuraman saving the king, because he is also the victim like the people of the place. Because all of them were blinded by the faith. They all were Andhbhakt. And the ending in reality, not having a happy, forced, unnatural ending. The film leaves the audience to think and ponder about. I'm so happy that this was India's official entry for the Oscars. This is well deserved. This was an ensemble cast and everyone was great, but nothing stood out as an exceptional performance to me. And that is fine as long as the film and the story works. Now this is not a perfect film at all. There are some issues with it. First, there are a lot of teachings in the film that I disagree with, especially with what a good woman is and how they should behave. I think a woman should decide that herself. Second, the screenplay and the pacing was off many times. I think they needed a lot of polishing. Now, I don't hold this against the film at all because I'm making this statement in 2020 and it doesn't count. Of course, it hasn't aged well, and if you haven't seen my video on why it's difficult to watch old films, go watch it. But again, it was not a problem for me because I just love this kind of films. I found the dialogues and the story too direct, especially in the first 30 minutes. Whenever two characters talk to each other, it feels like they are just exchanging exposition. They don't feel like real people. But now looking back at it, the film is driving a point, and it cannot be too subtle about it, because then the target audience will not get it at all. Because if they were so smart to get the subtleness, they wouldn't be blind at the first place, and you wouldn't have to make this film. Also, I felt that Mohanlal's character Raghuram, his arc didn't work for me. As soon as he came to the fictional world, he automatically changed, as if a switch is just flipped. I wish through the experiences in this world he had changed gradually, but it just happened in a flip. And I think that is also the issue of the story being so dense. Instead of one film, it could have been three films. We could have easily expanded the world and explored it more. But I can see that was not the intention of this film. But today, I would like this film to be remade as a three-part film with big stars and actors from every industry, because this story, this film is the need of the hour. You know, these are the kind of films that I want to make myself. A satire based in a fictional world, telling the story about the real world. Recent example of such film is Jojo's Rabbit. Now definitely there's a lot to unpack from this film. Do let me know in the comments if you want a live stream on this film. So guys, that was it. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, share this video, let me know in the comments your thoughts. If you haven't subscribed yet, check out the videos. If you like them too, do consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time.